Mister, excuse me.
Good morning, sir.
You must like living here.
All right, that's all.
You got any business?
All the best now.
I'll be seeing you.
I'm looking for an Arthur Londonderry. I was told he works here.
Londonderry?
Oh, you'll want to speak to the foreman. He's down in the pit.
Morning to you.
Morning to you.
Howdy.
Good morning, mister.
Hey, mister.
Morning.
Arthur Londonderry. She here?
I'm sorry, feller, but you're too late. Arthur's dead.
The man's dead. What's wrong with you?
Oh, boy. You can't exactly beat it out of him now, can you? You might get something off his widow just across from Butcher's Creek, but I'd hurry. You ain't gonna be the only one a-knocking.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Hey, I ain't the godforsaken moneylender.
Morning.
You've been the cause of enough sorrow around here.
Working hard there.
On your way now.
You ain't allowed around here.
It's all good. Calm down.
Time for you to be on your way.
Okay, boy. Is Londonderry.
Hawk is dead.
I know. I'm sorry for it. It's just... we land off for some money, you see.
thought it was you. What do you want now? You want my boy's shoes? You want the food out of our bellies? What little there is? Won't be that young.
No, no.
I'll forgive everything. The whole world. Everything. And now that some fellas are coming to take that house, there ain't nothing left, mister.
Just wanted to say, dead cats, to take this. You won't bring your husband back, I know. You need money, and I don't.
Well, you're a good man. I just wish you'd done it before he worked himself into the grave. But you know, maybe you and your friend that lent him the money could do things differently. Threatening me.
I'm sorry, man. Man. Yep.
Look at this, my friend. Tobacco. Nature's gift to us all. Focuses the mind like nothing else.
Whatever you say.
Well, I say, why buy it off the shelves when you can make your own? Well, plenty left here if you're interested. I'd best keep moving.
Well, shit. Thanks, I guess. Okay, boy. Hey there!
Get perfect, will ya?
simmer down. Here.
How did you get on, Mr. Morgan?
Just dandy. Mm. Just get up.
What?
Get up!
What is wrong?
Nothing's wrong. Nothing at all.
What are you doing?
Getting rid of you. You time-wasting maggot. Get your bag.
I don't understand.
Just get out of my sight. Waste my time, you depress me, and you're a parasite, sending me after losers like that. I should do. You're an embarrassment.
What are you doing? We were partners. Yeah. Business partners.
Go get a new partner.
You know, they say the sick delude themselves.
I was your comrade.
My comrade? You're a creep. Creeping a parasite and a time waster. Now, take that. Take that, and don't annoy me.
I'm
leaving.
Poor Karen.
Javier?
Dear sir, you were once very kind to Beau and myself, and it pains me to ask you to show us further kindness. But I have nowhere else to turn, and nobody else upon whom I can impose. I will, of course, pay you handsomely for your troubles. My family have turned quite mad and are threatening to send me away to stop my work, which they say is disgracing them. As if their history of absolute moral depravity, utter debauchery, and perpetual drunkenness did not disgrace them enough. I must escape, yet I am kept prisoner here. Can you help? Most days I am to be found at the cabins on the plantation. The main house and all it stood for are thankfully no more. Yours faithfully, Penelope Braithwaite.
Morning.
Glad to be home.
I almost wish we were back in Guam.
You okay, Mary Beth?
Are you okay, Arthur? What happened with Strauss?
There's nothing else for him left here. Maybe not for the rest of us, neither. Well, don't give up on everything just yet.
Uh-huh. Okay. Yep.
So, here we are.
I like what you've done with the place.
As long as it keeps folk away, I don't care. Long day ahead.
Fine morning.
Arthur, don't forget, I'm more than happy to craft you something if you bring me the right materials.
Thank you, Mr. Pearson. Morning.
Just when I think he might be a decent fella.
Okay, okay. Keep your hair on. Yep.
See if we can get through a morning with no argument.
You okay, Arthur? Sit down. Please.
I'm fine.
Remember, you don't look fine.
For sure. Well, I had some bad news.
Was it Mary?
No. No, not exactly. That's me. I'm sick.
Sick?
Yeah. I might die.
Oh. I'm so sorry.
Yeah. Me too. Me too.
Maybe you'll get better.
I don't think so.
Then I'm sorry.
Only the thing is, since then, I've started seeing things differently. I don't know. The whole world seems different somehow.
How so?
I can't explain it. Like better, almost.
Is that a good thing?
I guess it is. Only sometimes I ain't doing the good thing.
Maybe it's a sign, Arthur. Try to do the good thing.
I guess. Only it ain't always clear what that is. Not with the big stuff.
I know. Trust me, I know.
It's all over. All over. I don't want to die. Not like this. I don't want that. I don't. It's all so sad, Mr. Morgan. So very sad. I don't know.
I know things seem bad.
We're gonna die here.
Don't give up just yet. Okay, guess I'll see you later then.
Sure.
Karen?
Hey. Hello, Arthur. Gonna kick me out too, are you?
Giddy up. Susan?
Someone smashed the box.
What box?
The money box. We'd had that for so many years.
Why did they smash it?
Well, I don't know. Look at this place. All divided. Everyone anxious and at each other's throats. I'm heartbroken.
Yeah, me too. Me too. Well, try to keep your head straight.
I suppose.
Boy.
Hey. Hey, friend.
He's watching. He's always watching. He's never talking. They won't forgive you. They didn't forgive me. There is no forgiveness. None, friend.
Look out, mister.
I know you want it. I can smell it on you. Well, it ain't happening. No, it isn't. That's why I'm out here, well away from them. See, they come for me, but I'm watching. Yeah. I never sleep. I never do.
We don't have to breathe the same air, you know.
Okay, boy. Let's go.